السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Today is the 25th of December. You and I know it means it's Christmas Day according to some of the Christians. And I want to tell you why I say some of the Christians is because not all of the Christians believe that this was the day that Jesus was born. So, for those who do, and perhaps they may be in the majority, it's fine, it's their belief. As a Muslim, it's important for everyone to know where we stand when it comes to Jesus, may peace be upon him. I want to start off by saying, if you don't say, may peace be upon him, after saying the name Jesus, may peace be upon him, then you have disrespected the status of Jesus. May peace be upon him. In Islam, we are taught whenever you say the names of those who are close to Allah, you need to ensure that you say a word of recognition of that status and a prayer according to the teachings. You say Nuh or Noah, may peace be upon him. Abraham, may peace be upon him. Moses, may peace be upon him. Jesus, may peace be upon him. Muhammad, may peace be upon him. Or Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The plea, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. So this is something very interesting. Similarly, when you got the companions of these messengers, you need to say, may Allah be pleased with them. Abu Bakr, radiyallahu anh, may Allah be pleased with him. Umar, radiyallahu anh, may Allah be pleased with him. Jesus' birth is not only mentioned in the Quran, but it's mentioned in a special way in the Quran. There is a debate as to what the date was, even among the Christians. The reason is, there are verses in the New Testament, and even verses in the Quran, that prove that he was actually not born in winter. And therefore, one would say, if the fruit or the date was ripe at the time, like the Quran says to Mary, the mother, or Maryam, may peace be upon her, the mother of Jesus, may peace be upon him, when she was about to deliver this miracle child, Allah Almighty says, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطُ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيًّا فَكُلِي وَاشْرَبِي وَقَرِّي عَيْنًا. As she was struggling with the contractions of birth, Allah says, the palm tree, if you were to shake the trunk of it, it would drop the fresh, beautiful, ripe date. You would achieve comfort from it, you can eat from it, and so on. You and I know in winter that doesn't happen. The Middle East doesn't have fresh, ripe dates to fall off a tree by merely shaking it this time of the year. But Allah makes mention of that particular moment. And Allah Almighty speaks about the date of birth, or the day rather than the date. More than the date, the day. It was a blessed day, it was a day of peace, and Allah granted peace to Jesus, may peace be upon him, on that particular day and beyond. So who was Jesus? Jesus was a miracle given to the world by Allah as a gift. Jesus was chosen by Allah, may peace be upon him. His mother Mary, the daughter of Imran, wa Maryam ibnat Imran. Allah speaks about it. Allah says her name in full in the Quran. Maryam, the daughter of Imran, she was a virgin according to Islam. She was not married. She didn't have a husband according to Islam. So when we say Jesus is Kalimatullah, the word of Allah, what do we mean? I've seen videos of non-Muslims claiming that the word of Allah means the soul of Allah, rather than saying a soul from Allah, because Minallah, ruhum minhu, means a soul from Allah. It doesn't mean the soul of Allah. Because then they say, well, the Quran is saying he was the son, na'udhu billah, of Allah. But that's not what the Quran says. There are specific verses where Allah says he was not the son of Allah, but rather the word of Allah. That word, what is it? It is be. That's the word. So it's a literal word, it's an actual word. When we say this is the word of Allah, it means Allah said something and whatever He wanted came into being.
إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون.
Indeed, the instruction of the Almighty, whenever He wants something, is to say be and it is. So He just has to say be and it is. When He said be, it was. When He wanted to create Adam, He said be and he was. Eve, may peace be upon her, be and she was. Isa alayhi salam, be and he was. So the soul blown from Allah, by Allah, with the word be, in Arabic, kun. And that's why there is a famous Arabic saying, amruhu bayn al-kafi wa al-noon, which means the instruction of Allah is between the kaf and the noon, between the be and the e, be, and it is. So let's never be confused what is the meaning of the word of Allah. He is the result of the word of Allah. Kalimatuhu, the word of Allah, meaning a clear living example of be and he was. Allah creates in four ways and he showed us all four ways. There are four possibilities and probabilities. To create without the involvement of male or female, such as Adam, may peace be upon him. To create through a male without the involvement of a female, such as Eve, may peace be upon her. To create with the involvement of a female without that of a male, such as Jesus, may peace be upon him. And then through a male and a female, such as you and I. Such as you and I. May Allah bless all of us. Let's say Ameen. Ameen. You never know, it might be a moment of acceptance of dua and we're all blessed. Alhamdulillah. So, he was created that way, right?
وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيَّ يَوْمَ أُولِدْتُ وَيَوْمَ أَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ أُبْعَثُ حَيَّا.
Allah's peace be on Isa, Jesus, the son of Mary, the day he was born. This is a verse of the Quran where Allah repeats what he said by the instruction of Allah. Peace be upon me the day I was born. Which means that day is a blessed day, the day of the peace of Jesus, may peace be upon him. Allah blessed him with peace the day he was born, the day he shall die, and the day he will be resurrected thereafter. May Allah's peace and blessings be on him, and all the messengers, and on all of us. Ameen. So, what happened? Allah chose Mary, Maryam, the daughter of Imran, to be the person to carry this great prophet of Allah, this great word of Allah, whom the soul blown by Allah into the Virgin Mary in a way that she found herself expecting a miracle child without the involvement of any male. So the Islamic version, which we believe is the true, the accurate, the unchanged version, is that Joseph was not actually the husband or married to Maryam, may peace be upon her. She was a virgin. And when she found herself expecting, and when the angel came to her to tell her that you're expecting a child, you're expecting a miracle child, a prophet of Allah, she immediately questioned, how is this possible? And she was told, it's by the instruction of Allah. And Allah will help. Allah will help. Allah will guide. Allah will give. Allah will clear your name. And Allah has made him a prophet. And Allah has made him one of the highest prophets. If I were to ask you, who are the highest prophets? Would you know their names? There are five. Five of them. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibrahim alayhi salam. Musa alayhi salam. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abraham, may peace be upon him. Moses, may peace be upon him. Jesus, may peace be upon him. And Noah, may peace be upon him. These are the five highest ranking prophets of Allah. Allah mentions them in the Quran in more than one place. Let me read one of the verses.
وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ مِيثَاقَهُمْ وَمِنْكَ وَمِنْ نُوحٍ وَإِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ وَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُمْ مِيثَاقًا غَلِيظًا.
What a beautiful verse. Surah Al-Ahzab. Allah Almighty mentions all those five in one verse. And Allah calls them Ulul Azmi min ar-Rusul. They were the highest ranking of the prophet, of the prophets of Allah. They went through lives that Allah has mentioned most of in the Quran. The Quran is filled with stories of the prophets. The prophet mentioned the most in the Quran is
is Musa alayhi salam. Moses, may peace be upon him, well done. And then Allah makes mention of other prophets, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Jesus, may peace be upon him. There is an entire surah or chapter in the Quran named after Mary, Maryam, may peace be upon her, the mother of Jesus, may peace be upon him. And Allah mentions this whole story of how he was born and how everything happened and what he said when he was born, what happened when people accused Mary of doing something illegitimate or immoral. And Allah cleared her by making the child speak in the cradle. That's one of the miracles of Jesus, and he has had thousands of major miracles in his life. We'll mention some of them. But one of them was, and this one is not mentioned in the Old Testament or the Christian version of it, we believe that he spoke from the cradle. He spoke from the cradle, clarifying who he was. When people accused his mother, Ya Maryam, laqad ji'ti shay'an fariya, ya ukhta Harun, ma kana abuki imra'a saw', wa ma kanat ummuki baghiya. They looked at Mary and they said, you know what, you've come with something immoral, something sinful. Your father was a good man, your mother was a good woman. They were not immoral, immodest, they were chaste, subhanAllah, clean, pure, not like this. All she did by the instruction of Allah, فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ. Allah told her, you just point towards the child. Little baby in the cradle, newly born, what's going to happen? Allah says, you don't worry, just point at the child. They said, كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ صَبِيًّا. They said, how do you expect us to speak to someone who's in a cradle, a little baby in a cradle, you want him to talk? And he opened his mouth and he says, إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ آتَانِيَ الْكِتَابَ وَجَعَلَنِي نَبِيًّا وَجَعَلَنِي مُبَارَكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُ. Words that he said are mentioned in the Quran in Surah Maryam. Allah says, he says, I am the servant of Allah, a slave of Allah. Allah has made me a prophet and given me a book. Subhanallah, speaking about what is just going to happen. And Allah has made me blessed wherever I am. And Allah has granted purity, chastity to my mother. Jesus, remember, there are two things. One is religion and the other is ethnicity. Moments ago, my brother made a dua for the people of Palestine and Gaza, and we make a dua again. May Allah grant them goodness, protection, victory. May Allah safeguard them and may Allah grant them liberation. Ameen. There is a difference between religion and ethnicity. You're a Muslim, but you're not an Arab. Or you're a Jew, but you're not, for example, Middle Eastern. Or you might be a Christian, but you're an African. There is a massive difference between religion and ethnicity. Unfortunately, people brainwash the world into believing that in some cases, your religion and ethnicity is the same. No, it's not. No, it's not. You can follow a certain religion without being connected to the ethnicity of the prophet of that faith at all. How many of us come from all over the world? We don't lay a claim on Saudi Arabia or Mecca saying, because I'm a Muslim, that's it, it's my place, I own it. But unfortunately, that's what has happened in Palestine. May Allah Almighty grant the world the ability to distinguish between ethnicity and religion. Two different things. You could be of a religion, but not of an ethnicity. So Jesus, may peace be upon him, was from Banu Israel. He was a Jewish person. And Allah Almighty gave him a book and taught him and told him what to say to those who had forgotten the faith. They had quit their ways. They were involved in a lot of disobedience of Allah. So he came to remind them. What did they do to him? Wallahi, they accused him. They harmed him. They said his mother had brought a child of immorality, and it's all in their books. Subhanallah. May Allah protect us. So they harmed him, they harmed his people, they killed some of his companions or disciples and so on, and they did so much of evil. Towards the end, they even said, we killed him. Whereas in Islam, we believe they didn't kill anyone. Allah raised him before they could harm him. That's what the Quran says. And so we don't believe that Jesus was crucified, nor do we believe that he died and was resurrected. We believe he was alive and he was taken up by Allah, and he is still alive. How? However, Allah wants to keep him alive. And Allah is going to send him back onto the earth soon, towards the end of time. May Allah Almighty protect all of us and our belief. Ameen. So that's what we believe. A great man. Allah didn't allow someone to murder him. Allah took him up. So who did they murder? Allah says,
وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ.
They neither killed him nor did they crucify him, but they were confused. It was made confusing to them. They didn't know who was crucified, who was the one not crucified, who was crucified, because the faces were made similar. In one of the most common narrations, it is said that a man known as Judas Iscariot was the one who was the traitor who led the Romans to where Jesus was in order for them to kill him. And because of that sin of his, and because he betrayed Jesus, may peace be upon him, his face was changed to the face of Jesus. When the Romans came in, they thought they crucified Jesus, not realizing that Jesus is gone. Where did he go? He's up in the heavens. He's already lifted up. That's it. So who did you execute, or who did you crucify? Someone else, the traitor. May Allah Almighty grant us protection. So in the Quranic version, he was not crucified. Allah says, no, he wasn't crucified. Allah took him up. بَرَّفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ. Allah says clearly, but Allah has taken him up to him. And inshallah, he will come back towards the end of time. May Allah Almighty, once again we say, may Allah protect us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. Wallahi, we are blessed. My brothers, my sisters, listen to what Allah says. Allah says, he spoke when he was little, and indeed he taught a lot of goodness. He came with so many miracles, one after the other. And at that particular time, medicine was at its peak, at a certain type of peak. Allah says, Jesus was given the ability to get to a person who was pronounced dead by medicine, and that person would become alive by the permission of Allah through a miracle of Jesus, may peace be upon him. This is what Allah says. Allah says, Jesus, may peace be upon him, was given a miracle whereby there would be a form or a shape of a bird, a creature, a bird made with stone or clay, and he would blow in it, it would start flying. That was Jesus, may peace be upon him. Another miracle of Jesus, may peace be upon him, mentioned in the Quran, where a little bit of food would be enough for a lot of people. In fact, if you read the end of Surah Al-Ma'idah, Ma'idah meaning the laid tablecloth, speaking about what? According to a lot of the scholars of tafsir, that cloth, laid tablecloth, is what the Christians refer to as the Last Supper. Subhanallah. So there is a lot in common, but we believe the version we have is uncontaminated. And there are so many versions of the Bible, and so much dispute among the Christians themselves as to so many things. So because I don't want to go into all of that, all I need to do is, this is the 25th of December today, and I thought I'd seize the opportunity to let you know we revere Jesus. So much so that we should try and emulate. I mean, look at me. Subhanallah. I've got a beard, mashallah. I'm wearing some robe, subhanallah. When I know in Africa, when I walk about, a lot of the young people used to say, hey, Jesus, Jesus, you know. There was a little boy once saying to his mom that, I think God has come. And I'm looking like, no way, man. Come on. Don't, you know, behave yourself, man. Come on. But that was their belief, because according to them, not me, we are not allowed to make portraits and so on. According to them, subhanallah, rabbil alameen, guess what? They said Jesus had a beard, he wore robes and so on. Mary, the Virgin Mary. The Christians are the ones who say how she dressed and what she dressed like and so on. The Muslim women are the closest to that. No debate, no debate. And when we try to do that, they start saying, no, you're oppressed and you're wrong. Well, if Mary was here, she would have been the biggest oppressed person according to them. And Jesus would have been probably an extremist or whatever else. May Allah protect him, and his reputation is intact. Inshallah, it will remain intact. But Allah says in the Quran that a day will come when we will ask Jesus, did you tell the people to worship you and your mother besides me? And he will say, no chance, no ways. I didn't say a thing that you didn't instruct me to say. I told them to worship the Maker alone, but they started worshiping me, and so on. So why does Allah make mention of the mother?
وَإِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّي اتخذوني وأمي إلهين من دون الله قال سبحانك.
The day when Allah will ask Jesus, may peace be upon him, did you tell the people to worship you and your mother? So some of the people say, well, no one worships the mother. No, they do. There are so many factions of the Christians. There are groups that worship both Jesus and the mother. In Islam, any act of worship rendered, or when you ask someone something beyond a certain point, it's considered worship. I can ask you, my brother, can you please give me a glass of water? I can see the water, I can see the glass, I can know the ability of this person and so on. That's not worshiping the brother. I'm just simply asking him for something I know that he can actually do right here, right in front of me. But the minute I say, grant me happiness, grant me so on, salvation and so on, that's now on a level of worship. That's for Allah alone. You ask Allah, oh Allah, grant me happiness, oh Allah, grant me cure and so on. That's Allah. That's for Allah alone. So, if you know, in a lot of the churches, and again the Christians are divided whether or not they should be having statues. Many Christians believe you're not allowed to have statues. The Jews actually believe it's totally forbidden to have statues. And the Muslims believe it's forbidden to have statues, just like the Jewish belief. And some of the Christians also believe the same. They don't believe in the cross. Some of the Christians don't believe in the cross. And so what happened? Subhanallah. They put up statues of both Jesus and Mother Mary, and therefore you see in a lot of the churches there's both those statues. This is what Allah is saying, ittakhidhuni wa ummiya. He mentioned both of those, yourself and your mother. It's not just out of something. People say the Quran is wrong because no one worships the mother of Jesus. No, they do. Maybe you don't know. It's like someone says, well, you know what, we don't know all the sects. Well, I'm telling you, there are sects who worship the mother, their ghost. So bottom line is, Jesus taught to worship the Maker alone. That's it. And that's why from among the Christians, there are those who don't believe in the Trinity. Did you know that? Yes, they are. From among the Christians, there are those who don't believe the 25th of December is actually the day of Christmas, the day of the birth of Jesus. When I went to Ethiopia, sometime in January, they said, well, this is the birth of Jesus. And they were Orthodox Christians. And I got to talk to them and so on. A lot of beautiful detail I learned. Some say, no, it was actually July, August, because that's the time when the date is ripe. And when you shake the tree, it actually falls down. Well, subhanAllah, in Islam, we do not know the exact date. But all we know is the day Jesus was born, blessed day. We're happy. We're excited. He was a messenger. He came about with goodness. He taught the Ten Commandments. We adopt them. We accept them. We acknowledge them. The first one is to worship Allah alone. That's the first commandment. Subhanallah. Not to associate partners with Allah. It's like saying, La ilaha illallah. That's literally the first commandment. May Allah Almighty grant us life upon that and death upon that. Ameen. So I tell you, my brothers and sisters, why I mention this is because we are taught to respect everyone, no matter what their beliefs are. But respecting someone does not mean that I need to agree with you. No, I don't need to agree with you. I don't agree with you, but I respect you. And you know what? It's live and let live. You respect me, but you disagree with me. So it's not like I'm allowing you or you're allowing me. We're on earth and we have our natural human rights. What's the human right? I can disagree with you. You call this color behind me purple, I might call it whatever else, beige or something. You might disagree and say it's brown. Fair enough, we disagree. Perhaps your eyes are tinted slightly different from mine. It's okay. Your understanding, my understanding, it's not the end of the world. So we respect people of other faiths. They celebrate on this day, let them celebrate on this day. I don't. I celebrate on another day. For what? For something else altogether. My celebration and the way I do it is different. Their celebration and the way they do it is different. Alhamdulillah. That's why the Quran tells us, لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينٌ. You have your faith, I have mine. There we go. You don't impose on me, I don't impose on you. There we are. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. So my brothers and sisters, we have the goodness. We have so much of goodness from Allah Almighty. We need to understand, don't become hurtful, abusive, and filled with hate in the way you communicate, in your behavior, in your speech and words. Whether it's online, offline, wherever it is, be respectful. And this is why some people say, well, you know what? if they are so hateful against us and say bad words, can't we say bad words against them? The truth of the matter is no. In Islam, it doesn't mean if someone swore at you, you can swear them back. Allah says,
وَلَا تَسُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَسُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ.
Don't mock at or joke at or abuse those who are calling out to deities besides Allah, because then they would do the same to Allah as a result of that and without knowledge. Who caused it? You would have caused it. Don't do that. There's no point. People are worshipping deities besides Allah. Allah says, don't mock at them. Don't scoff at them. Don't joke about them. Don't abuse them. Don't belittle them. No. You can disagree in a respectful way and discuss what you believe is the truth, and they have the same right to discuss with you what they believe is the truth. That's when you are going to come to a common ground where they can understand. We can all settle on what is the ultimate truth if we're really searching for it. And that's why in Islam, one of the most repeated du'as ever, ever is, guess what? Do you guys know? I said it in one of the motivational evenings before. The most repeated phrase in the whole world in existence is Allahu Akbar. Because billions of people say it hundreds of times every day, including you and I. Allahu Akbar. Hands down, nobody can debate. Allah is the greatest, is the most repeated phrase in existence. For one salah, I need to say it so many times. For adhan, it is said. For iqama, it is said. Allahu Akbar. That's the most repeated phrase in existence. And then there is the most repeated supplication in existence. What is it? Anyone knows?
اهدنا الصراط المستقيم.
Guide us to the straight path. Allahu Akbar. The dua for guidance is the most repeated on earth. I pray 17 units of prayer a day, 17 times minimum. I say, oh Allah, guide us to the straight path, the path of those whom you have favored and not the path of those who have earned your anger or those who have gone astray. That's what I say every day. And who says it with me? Billions, billions. So alhamdulillah, we are very concerned with guidance. We always ask Allah, guide us to the straight path, guide us to the straight path. And Allah says, if you ask me truly, sincerely, and you're searching in a correct, proper way, we will guide you. We will, if you are striving towards achieving the guidance, we will definitely guide you to the straight path. So we are filled with respect. When they made cartoons against Muhammad, peace be upon him, we said we would be equally hurt if they did the same for Moses, may peace be upon him, or Jesus, may peace be upon him, because these are messengers of Islam. I don't worship him, but I follow him to the T. I know people who claim to worship, but they don't even follow. How's that? I met one of the priests. I told him, my brother, you're wearing a suit and a tie and you're going to the church. Whatever it is, it may be permissible according to whatever. It's fine. But my point was, if I were to walk into your church and come and give a talk, I probably look more like Jesus than you. It's a fact. And he didn't feel so happy about it because he said, look, what you said is irrelevant. I said, I'm just making a point. That's all. I'm just making a point. It's like the Muslim girls, subhanAllah, and the women. People hate on us simply because we're dressed like the Mother Mary, may peace be upon her. It shouldn't be the case. This morning, I retweeted a lecture in Bethlehem by one of the reverends, by one of the priests. People might be surprised. Why is he retweeting it? Because many people don't know that Palestine, Gaza, as well as the West Bank and so on, has a large number of Christian Arabs who are there, who are pure Christians, and they believe in Jesus in whatever way they believe in Jesus. And for them, Bethlehem and this day is sacred. And they were unable to celebrate on this day. The celebrations were cancelled because they are also being killed the same way the Muslims are being killed, simply because they are Arab, they are Palestinian. That's what is happening. It's happening today. So a lot of the people out there who may not know the difference between Judaism and Zionism, they think that it's all about Jews. It's not about Jews. It's about Zionism and it's about Palestine. It's about the ethnic or the indigenous people of the place. Where are you from, my brother? I'm a Muslim. I come from Pakistan, for example. It's okay. I love you. You can't just come and claim my home and say, listen, I'm Muslim. This is my place. Out. Come on. What's your ethnicity? Let's get it checked for you. May Allah Almighty protect us. May Allah protect all of us. All the people of Palestine are asking for is justice. Nothing more than that. They want fairness, and people have lived of all three faiths, major faiths, and perhaps even more than that, for centuries. What happened? Things went wrong. That you can go and look at the history of. The point here is Jesus, may peace be upon him. What a great man. What a great man. He came, he struggled, he strove. He went through problem after problem. They tried to kill him. They harmed his disciples. And we believe in all of these disciples, great men, mashallah. Allah speaks about them in the Quran. And Allah speaks about this Hawariyun. And Allah says, when Jesus asked them who is going to help in the cause of Allah, they all said, we will help. We will come in the cause of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I want to remind you and I, if those great men struggled in the cause of their faith, do you really think we're not going to struggle? Our struggles are going to be smaller than theirs, less than theirs, but there will be struggles. Every prophet who came faced the wrath of his people to a degree. Abraham, what happened? Wallahi, one of the greatest of the prophets of Allah. Do you know his community didn't even accept his message? Allah actually says, فَآمَنَ لَهُ لُوطُ. Lot was one of them who accepted the message. His wife was another one who accepted the message, and so on. What happened? Slowly but surely, the numbers multiplied over the generations. Today, Abraham, the father of all those who are fighting at the moment in the Middle East, the father of all of them. Imagine if he was here, subhanAllah. May Allah grant us goodness. May Allah grant us peace in the world. May Allah grant us the ability to respect one another. May Allah grant us the courage to stand up for what is just and fair. And may Allah Almighty guide us to what really happened and what is really happening. May we not be fooled. I sit and watch the Christians within Palestine and how they are suffering. And I think to myself, imagine other Christians of the world are sometimes excited about Palestinians being killed, and they don't realize some of them are actually Christian just like you are. You shouldn't be excited that way. You don't know the history. You don't even know what's going on. You have no clue, and you don't even want to know, because you've been involved in entertainment in a way that you've just been entertained by falsehood such that you believe that it's true, sadly. May Allah Almighty protect us. You know, my brothers and sisters, on this day, we should seize the opportunity. We should seize the opportunity to renew our knowledge about Jesus, may peace be upon him, Mary, may peace be upon her, exactly what happened, and so on. In order for us to connect once again with such great prophets of Allah and their teachings, amazing teachings, beautiful teachings. And do you know, if you look at my struggles and yours, you will find that they struggled more than us. What problems do you have? I wanna tell you something interesting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, and he is basically giving us a challenge. He says, count the favors upon you, you won't be able to. In more than one place in the Quran, Allah says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you are going to count the favors of Allah, you won't be able to do that. You won't count them. How many gifts of Allah do you have? Let's start from the top. Okay, I don't have hair, but anyway, you guys. So let's start from the top, right? Your hair, what else? Your skull, your skin. You come down. This forehead here of yours, mashallah, some people don't have it. May Allah grant us protection. And then you have your eyebrows, alhamdulillah. Some of them actually shave them off, astaghfirullah. But you have your eyebrows, alhamdulillah. And then you have your nose, and you can breathe, and you have your eyes, even with glasses, without glasses, with laser, with contact lenses, without contact lenses, colored contact lenses, plate contact lenses, plastic glass, whatever it is. You have it. Alhamdulillah. What else? Imagine if one of these things I mentioned right now is gone. One. You wouldn't even want to live. And then your nose and then your ears, no matter how big or small they are, can you hear? You can hear me, right? Even if you have a little machine, thank Allah, but you can hear me. Can't you hear me? If you can't hear me, I can raise my voice. I can start screaming, okay? Nonetheless, let's go down. You have lips, mashallah. You have a tongue. You can eat. You have some teeth. If not teeth, you have some implants. If not implants, you have dentures. If not dentures, subhanAllah, you've got something. But you're chewing, you're eating, mashallah. Alhamdulillah, you can chew your food. We haven't even gone down. Wallahi, I tell you, look within yourself. Hundreds of thousands, if not millions of things. You keep counting and counting and counting every single day. Allah promises you. Allah challenges you. Count, you won't be able to. But the opposite is true. What is it? What we've tested you with, you can count it. Allahu Akbar. Have you ever thought of that? Many people don't think of it. If I ask you how many major issues or how many issues do you have in life, negativity, you tell me, don't have a job. That's one thing. What else? I lost such and such a person. That's another thing. Okay, what else? Don't have a house. That's a third thing. What else? You mention 10 things and you stop. Doesn't really normally go more than that. But your life is finished. Allah says, wait, I've given you so many gifts, one after the other. For every one problem that you have, I've given you a million gifts. That's what Allah says. Well, not exactly that figure, but He means He's blessed you much more than He's tested you. But He's tested. And so Allah says, when He loves you, He tests you. He wants you to bear patience. Bear patience. Because perfection is for the hereafter. It's for paradise. And Allah will give it to you and grant you, and Allah will open your doors. So take it in your stride. May Allah Almighty bless every one of us. You know, when I see Brother Ubaidah walking, I get excited. I asked earlier, when is he coming? And they said, tomorrow we'll see him. But mashallah, he just walked in now. Mashallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. I want to acknowledge this evening, we have people from far and wide. We have people from as far as New York and other parts of Europe and somewhere else, and mashallah, someone from Dubai, a family, and alhamdulillah, you are more than welcome. May Allah bless you all. I pray and hope that inshallah we can gather in Jannatul Firdaus. Some of you are joining us in February for the Umrah trip, alhamdulillah. I think there are a few seats remaining, maybe 5 or 6, I think. Yeah. And inshallah, the others, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. I was so happy to see all the faces one by one coming. Everyone bright and beaming, everyone excited and happy. It made me happy and excited too. Lovely to have you this evening. We hope that Allah gives us more and more opportunities. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.